Hello students, as we have already discussed about the nuclear reaction and certain types of nuclear reaction, in this lecture we will discuss about the other types of nuclear reaction. So in this lecture our first type is pickup and stripping reaction. So what is pickup reaction? When we strike an incident particle or when we collide an incident particle on a target nucleus, it just picks up an nucleon from the target nucleus and the new particle is produced. So this concept can be easily understood by using an example. Suppose this is copper 29 copper 63. When we strike or when we collide an deuterium atom on the copper, then the copper 64 is produced. Here it is copper 64. Okay, copper 64 is produced with the emission of proton atom. So what happens here, why it is called pickup or stripping reaction? Just because copper just picks up an nucleon from the deuterium atom. So copper 63 changes into copper 64, here it is 64. Copper 63 is converted into copper 64 by just pick up an nucleon from the deuterium atom. And why it is called stripping reaction? Just because our deuterium atom, that is 1H2 deuterium atom, just lose its one of the nucleon to the copper. So it just strips an nucleon to the copper. So this is known as pickup or stripping reaction. Okay. Now the next one is fission and spallation reaction. We already know that what is fission. Fission is just breaking off heavier nucleus into small fragments. Just heavier nucleus into small particles, small nucleons. Okay, so consider an example of uranium. This is actually the naming reaction that is known as uncontrolled nuclear reaction. Okay, so when we strike, when we hit and target nucleus uranium with the incident particle neutron, then it is converted into two another nucleons, that is barium and krypton. Not just barium and krypton, but with the another three neutrons with lot of amount of energy. So this reaction is known as fission reaction. What happens here, just strike one neutron on the uranium and we will get barium and krypton together with three neutrons and lot of amount of energy. So this is the fission reaction. There is a great example of fission reaction is hydrogen bomb. What happens in hydrogen bomb? Fission takes place. Okay. So another one is spallation reaction. Fission and spallation reaction. We have already considered the example of uranium. Only two new nucleons are produced. When we consider the spallation reaction, very high energy is produced and large number of particles are produced. Almost 20 to 30 fragments, new fragment nucleus are produced. So just one to new particles are produced. This is fission reaction. If there is a huge number of particles are produced, almost 20 to 30 fragments, then this reaction is known as spallation reaction. Okay. Hanji, next one is disintegration reaction. Disintegration reaction, just we know that when we interacting particle is absorbed by the target nucleus and into a different particle is ejected from the target particle, this process is known as disintegration reaction. Now consider the example lithium. When incident particle alpha particle is strike on a target particle lithium, then it absorbs some of its nucleons, then it is converted into boron. So it is converted into 5 boron 10 with mass number 10 and the new particle, outgoing particle is produced, that is the neutron. Okay. So similarly we can consider the another example of tritium and gamma particle. So outgoing particle produced is deuterium and neutron. So okay students, another types we will discuss in the next lecture.